It took a sleepless week of data crunching, but I eventually tracked down the location of my friends, locked away in the mysterious towers of Prague. At the moment, they are the unwilling guests of Interpol's most renowned prison warden, the Contessa. While still a criminal psychology student, she entered into a whirlwind romance and married a wealthy aristocrat. Sadly, the union was short-lived, as the general suspiciously died a few weeks after the ceremony. The widowed Contessa put her education and newly acquired estate to work by opening a criminal rehabilitation center. Her pioneering use of hypnotherapy has produced some good results and subsequently earned her a prominent position within Interpol. My friends are locked up somewhere in the clinic and are slated for the Contessa's Good Samaritan brainwashing. If I don't bust them out soon, they'll be working a 9-to-5 job selling shoes, and I'll be out two best friends. I should make my way over to the Contessa's house. Maybe I'll pick up a few leads on the location of Sly and Murray. The Contessa is out making her rounds. Wait a second. The feathers on my sleep darts vibrate near sounds. If I maintain my position on top of this parabolic dish, I should be able to hear that frequency at a distance. This is great! If I tag the Contessa with my darts, I'll be able to listen in on whatever she says. I might even learn where she's locked up Sly and Murray.
The Claw Gang is falling apart. Spy shipments have all but stopped. I never would have joined if I'd known it would be this easy to disrupt the plan. At least the Cooper Gang is under lock and key. Their lopsided morality flies in the face of man's inherent selfishness. Ah well, they'll see it my way soon enough. Those fools at Interpol! They keep sending me criminals and I keep making money. How come no one ever thought of this before? Hypnotize criminals and force them to reveal where they've hidden their fortune. I'm a genius! If only I had more spice to help me with the hypnosis. That blasted Cooper gang! The fat one. What's his name? Murray. Yes, Murray. He'll be the first to break. I should spend a few sessions probing that feeble mind. I can only imagine the wealth that gang has accumulated over the years. That's Sly Cooper. Such a complex and rebellious mind. A month or two in the hole should break his spirit. Let him squat there week after week. He's seen that the guards along the wall all have motion detectors. There is no escape. Slowly, the reality of his captivity will set in, and I'll get to work on his mind.
Inconceivable! She's no healthcare professional! Why, that's the most heinous crime I've ever heard of! Putting inmates into hypnosis so they'll tell her where they've stashed their loot. It dishonors both law enforcement and thieves at the same time. I should get to work and figure out a way to break Sly out of the hole. Computer is part of a control system for the electromagnetic tray. By hacking all the terminals along the train tracks, I should be able to reverse their polarity, thereby turning the train into a giant projectile. Without question, its impact on the prison walls should create a hole large enough for Sly to escape through. A good computer hack job. Now the left analog stick should control my cyber avatar. I'll have to hack through these barrier nodes. I should move the right analog stick in the direction I want to unleash my hacker code. By using both analog sticks at the same time, I'll be able to move and shoot in different directions. That's one down. The train should be picking up speed. down, four more to go. That should speed up the train by at least 50%. Just two more terminals. The train's at full speed. Now, on to reverse the field's polarity. What a beautiful trajectory! Bullseye!
Ah!
of the guards along the prison wall are outfitted with a motion tracking device. There's no way for Sly to escape. Unless I take those guys out with my RC chopper.
How I missed that sensuous voice of yours.
Save the jocular comments for later. Do you see that hook above the train?
Yeah.
It's your only means of escape. Jump and hit the circle button to grab hold, then swing onto the back of the train. I've already established a safe house and downloaded its GPS coordinates into your binoculcom. We'll rendezvous there.
Wow, you've really thought of everything.
Don't I always?
Yeah. You do. Thanks for busting me out.
Oh, well, you know the old saying, if you can't count on a friend to bust you out of jail, what kind of a friend are they?
Truer words were never said, wizard.
Okay, here's the situation. I've done some deep database crunching and figured out that Murray is doing time in cell block D. Getting him out is going to be tough. As you know, he's not very light on his feet. First, we'll need to get Murray into an isolation cell away from the other inmates. Second, I'll need you to get a sample of the Contessa's encryption algorithm. Don't worry, I'll explain later. Third, you'll need to pickpocket a few keys from the Contessa, but watch out for her pack of bodyguards. And fourth, you'll have to deactivate her giant attack robot. No, really, Sly, I'm serious. The Contessa has a giant attack robot. It just looks like a water tower. Now, once you've pulled off all these jobs, we'll be ready to make a play for the big guy.
Thank you.
Under the bridge feed power to the prison security systems. I'll need to cut the connection to free Murray.
Sounds like a plan. What do you need me for?
As you know, the bridge is heavily guarded.
I hear you. You'd like a little protection while you place the bombs.
That's correct.
Love to help out, but there's nowhere to hide on the bridge. We're totally exposed.
That's true. To fool the guards, you'll need to break those statues and take their place.
I pose like a statue, the guards walk on by, then, pow, I hit him from behind. You're a genius.
That's also correct.
Here. Follow me to the top of the bridge.
This bomb's all set. I'm moving to the next stress point. The third bomb's in position. I am en route to set the fourth. I'm on the move.
To the security system.
No problem. I'm an old hand at pickpocketing.
This is going to be tougher than you think. The Contessa's no fool. Since your escape, she never goes anywhere without bodyguards. You'll have to take them out one by one in order to get close to her.
I should probably know how to use ways to lure them away from the Contessa.
Goes there,
huh?
Where are my guards? Huh? Huh? They're gone again. What? Huh? Where are those lazy bodyguards? They're all fired.
Great work. Now we're all set up to steal a tank.